Hi, I'm Shane Suter, Artistic Director at City on a Hill Productions. And I'm so excited that you've chosen to journey through one of our Bible study resources. This multi-episode study combines dramatic storytelling and insightful teaching. It's designed for use in small groups as a video-driven Bible study that's completely different from anything you've experienced before. But our studies are also great for individual or family use as a perfect tool for devotionals or discipleship. Here's how it works. At each get-together, the group watches a 25 to 30 minute DVD episode. Each segment unfolds a dramatic story coupled with insightful teaching, presented in a highly cinematic style. The format is a little difficult to describe. You just have to see it to appreciate it. So I'd encourage you to go ahead, check out a couple of episodes, see what you think, experience it for yourself. After viewing the DVD, the host then leads an open discussion around the ideas that have been communicated in the presentation. Now, the host doesn't have to be a teacher. In fact, it's better if the host doesn't teach. The host should facilitate the conversation. Keep the discussion moving. Make sure the atmosphere is open and non-judgmental and conversational. Let the Holy Spirit and the DVD do the teaching. You just urge people to share their ideas. Facilitating discussion will give people a chance to think through things, to talk through their opinions and their beliefs, and consider their response to the person and message of Jesus Christ. Each discussion should last maybe 30 to 45 minutes. How do you host a City on a Hill Bible study small group? Well, first, watch through this video leaders tutorial and get a feel for all the concepts. Then watch all the DVDs and read through the leader's guide. Trust me, I don't think this is going to feel like homework. This will be entertaining, moving, and a real blessing in your own spiritual walk. Begin to envision what could happen. What could God do through you if you led a group like this? And next, ask the Father for wisdom. Is God leading you to do something like this? If so, then ask Him for His guidance on who you might invite to join you in organizing a group like this. You don't want to put this together alone, especially if you aren't working in conjunction with a church campaign or small groups ministry. You'll need some help along the way. Begin putting out feelers to those who you think might want to be a part of making this small group. Loan out some of the DVDs to friends, get their reactions, and while everyone's interest and enthusiasm is high, begin inviting people to attend. We believe that this is a study that will prompt a lot of discussion. So keep your meetings to a reasonable length by avoiding building a group larger than a dozen people. After you've gotten the hard part behind you by inviting people to the group, it's time to begin. Here's a typical timetable of what a gathering might look like. Spend the first 30 minutes enjoying snacks and fellowship. The next 30 minutes watching the DVD episode, and then close with a 45-minute discussion. Everyone is in and out in less than 2 hours. Respect everyone's time and don't run over, and you'll have a group eager to return for the next session. The role of the discussion guide is critical to the success of this journey. So here are some really important tips. Please don't skip over this. Make sure you really digest these concepts and then go over these tips with other team members and ask them to give you their feedback after the discussion time. I know it's a little bit scary, but trust me, it'll help. Here are some principles for leading healthy discussion times. First, pray. Ask God to give you wisdom, to give you a listening ear and a peace that passes understanding. 2 Timothy 1:7 says that we should pray for a spirit of power, of love, and self-discipline. The leader's guide contains a number of possible questions that you could ask, but these questions don't have to be asked exactly as they're written. Feel free to rephrase the questions to make them more your own. The more conversational you can be, the better. And as you ask questions, keep in mind that the most important thing that you need to do is listen, really hear what people are saying. Don't worry so much about what you're going to say next. Instead, really listen, and then respond out of what you hear people say. Another important key is to be sure not to give your opinion about an issue unless it's already fully discussed. Some people will see you as the leader, and once you speak, they'll shut down. So if somebody asks for your opinion, you might say, I'll be glad to give it, but I'd really like to hear from everyone else first. A real key is to not just ask one question right after another, but to follow up on what someone says. This makes the discussion more like a conversation than a lesson. So, a few good follow-up questions or responses to have in your back pocket might be, explain what you mean, or do you have an example of that, or when did you start thinking or feeling that way? How confident are you that that's true? How well does that work in your life? It's important that as a leader, you affirm all the responses and let people know immediately that you appreciate their participation and contribution. No matter what participants say, don't criticize their remarks. What they just said may be antagonistic to you, it may simply sound ridiculous, but don't directly criticize it. Instead, say something like, "That's interesting. What do the rest of you think?" Once you, as the leader, directly disapprove of someone's comments, then some people are never going to speak up again. They're going to fear disapproval. And once exploration stops for them, then the journey stops too. But on the other side of the coin, while it's important to affirm all responses, avoid the temptation to endorse them. Don't say things like, "Now, that's a great comment," or "I couldn't agree with you more." Such endorsements tip your hand and leave others feeling like their comments aren't acceptable. Also, resist the urge to be too instructional, trying to answer everyone's questions and solve everyone's problems. Because once a know-it-all person speaks up, conversation tends to shut down. You can give your own opinion, but do it in a personal and humble way. Maybe you say, "Well, my experience has been," or "This is how I see it." You'll want to be careful to talk enough, but not talk too much. A little silence can be a good thing for a group. Don't try to fill every quiet moment. Do your best to listen to the spirit as well as the conversation. Be praying silently all through the DVD and the discussion time, asking for the sensitivity and wisdom to listen and then guide without controlling. So, what do you do if you have a difficult or domineering or excessively talkative person in your group? Here's some ideas. First, if somebody is talking on, interrupt nicely and say, "I see what you mean," or "I hear what you're trying to say. Let's see how others feel about that." Or another thing you might want to do if somebody is regularly talking too much, you might say, "I'd like to make sure that everyone has a chance to say something before the rest of us speak a second time." Also, if somebody continues to just dominate the group or the discussion time, step aside with him or her after a session and say something like, "I see you have a lot of ideas and you're really willing to express them, and I appreciate that. I need your help. Some of the others in the group, they're not as bold, so would you help me draw them out? If we could provide more opportunity for them, I think they're going to begin to share. So if you could help me with that, that'd be great." But what if you have a person in your group who never talks and who's reluctant to share? You might say something like, "Does anyone who hasn't spoken up yet have a thought or an idea?" If that doesn't work, and if the spirit is prompting you, then maybe you say, "Hey, Kevin, I noticed you haven't said anything yet. You don't have to, but I'd sure be interested in hearing what you think about this." I know that may be a ton of information for you to digest, but don't worry. Above all, just love each person in the group, because if you truly care about them, they're going to sense it, and the Holy Spirit will flow through.